Welcome to lesson 2 in the course on learning outcomes in dental education. The lesson 2 is taxonomy in learning outcomes. This lesson will guide in understanding levels in taxonomy for writing learning outcomes. Let's get started. Let's discuss on the context of the course and its relation to learning outcomes. In short, we call as LO. Brainstorming the essential keywords that is central to the course or program is very important in the writing of the LO and the lesson objectives. This can be identified and related from the generalizable skills that a student will ultimately learn from the course or the program. The context and the type of learning is unique and characteristic to the program or course, and these should be considered as potential keywords. The identified keywords will provide a contextual relationship of the learning outcome objectives to the program or course. For example, in an undergraduate dental education, towards becoming a BDS, few keywords that will be are like dental practice, patients, oral health, professionalism, communication, skills. What are the levels of learning? A taxonomy is a hierarchical classification system that is structured from simple to complex and general to abstract. There are the three domains of cognition, psychomotor skills, and affective or feeling domains. The hierarchical structure requires that preliminary levels be mastered before learning at higher levels can occur. Writing learning outcomes with the help of taxonomies helps in developing precise LOs aligned to the appropriate level of learning expected from the learners. Use of taxonomies in LO will help design appropriate assessment and evaluation methods. Let's get a little of the history of the taxonomy we are interested in. Benjamin Bloom and his colleagues developed the cognitive domain in 1956. Affective domain also was developed around the same time, but it underwent further few modifications. Cothwell and colleagues, which included Bloom also, published the affective domain taxonomy in 1964. Psychomotor has a different taxonomy, but the most popular in health profession education is the Simpsons, who developed it in 1970. Other psychomotor taxonomies which are available are by Haros in 1972 and Dave in 1975. The cognitive domain of learning. The learning in this domain is concerned with mental or thinking processes and skills related to it. The mental skills that can be associated with the domain are information processing, constructing and understanding from the knowledge accrued, applying the learning in similar or different settings or context, problem solving, and conducting research. The psychomotor domain of learning. The learning in this domain is on discrete physical functions, reflex actions and interpretative movements, and how they are managed and coordinated to achieve a specific work. The development of gross and fine motor skills are the realm of this domain. Though there is a mental processing in the initial learning of the motor skill, there is not much mental thought given when automation of the skill is being achieved or achieved. The affective domain. The learning in this domain is associated with feelings, emotions, attitudes, beliefs, and values, leading to characterization of an individual. Affective and cognitive are highly connected. For example, an interest in learning is required to gain or apply knowledge. Interest is affective domain, while gaining knowledge comes under the cognitive domain. The learning in this domain aims to trigger growth in feelings or emotional areas to the expected outcome of the professional job throughout the learning experience. In summary, an effective program should have the right mix of learning in all the three domains of cognition, psychomotor, and affective for a holistic development of the graduate. The learning outcomes, or LO, in the various domains should complement and support each other. The learning activities and assessment varies as the direction in each domain is different.